Good morning, children. This is fifth standard English class. Hope you all have completed your block 6 classwork and workbook, children. Today we are going to start with block number 7. Writing your review. Writing a review. And today's topic is subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. So let me explain you what is subject. So to know about subject and predicate, we have to know about the sentence. Every complete sentence has two parts, children. Every complete sentence has two parts. One is subject and the other is predicate. Okay, now let me explain you what is a subject. A subject consists of the name of a person, place, thing, animal or idea. Animal or idea, I-D-E-A, idea. Subject means in a sentence a noun should be there. That means it should consist of name of a person, place, thing, animal or idea. And what is a predicate? It consists of verb. That means the action which is done. In every sentence we have subject and predicate, that is one noun and the other is action. Okay, example. I'll give you one example. I walk to school every day. I walk to school every day. In this, what is the subject, children? What is the noun over here? I is the noun, that is subject, right? And what is the verb, action I'm doing here? Walk. So this is the predicate. Always the subject will be a noun and the action comes under predicate. Okay. This is about subject and predicate. Not only this, we are having compound subject and compound predicate, which I am going to explain you now. Okay, children? Once again, I am telling you, children, about subject and predicate. Every complete sentence has two parts. Every complete sentence has two parts. One is subject and the other is predicate. Subject means what? It consists of the name of a person, place, thing, animal or idea. And these all belong to noun. When it comes to predicate, it is an action verb. It is a verb and that is an action. Example, I walk to school every day. I is a subject over here and walk is an action which is being done over here. Hope you all understood this. Okay. So, just now I have explained you about subject and predicate, children, with a single subject and single predicate. Now I am going to explain you what is compound subject. Compound subject has two or more subjects connected by a convention. What compound subject has? Two or more subjects. That means two or more nouns. Okay. And they both are connected by a convention. What are conventions? Remember, fanboys. Yes. All subjects in a compound subject have the same verb or predicate. Here we are having two or more subjects, but the predicate will be only one. Here I have given one example. See, Surya and Teja played with the ball. Here two nouns are there. One is Surya and the other is Teja. These two nouns are there and they both are connected with the convention. So this is a subject over here. Surya and Teja played with ball. And what is the predicate? Played, action.
and only one predicate they have been used. This is what is called as compound subject. Okay. Now compound predicate children. Compound predicate has two or more predicates. How many predicates does a compound predicate have? Two or more. That means the action will be two or more. Now, connected by a convention. All predicates in a compound predicate have the same subject. Same like the compound subject, it is also the same children, but here two or more predicates will be there. Okay, and these are also connected by a convention. See the example over here children. Surya, it is one subject. Surya likes to read and write. Surya, only one subject, one noun. And what does he like to do? Read and write. This is the action what he is doing. Here two predicates are there. Two predicates. Read, one action. Write, one action. So two predicates. And they are joined by, connected by a conjunction. So this is what is compound predicate. In a sentence, we can have two compound subjects and two compound predicates also. One example I will show you children. See here children, a sentence can also have both a compound subject and a compound predicate. In one sentence, we can have both compound subject and compound predicate. Here I have given one example, you see. The cats and dogs fought all day and slept all night. Here what is a compound subject? The cats and dogs is a compound subject. Here two subjects are there and connected by a convention, right? Now, here see the predicate. Fought all day and slept all night. What did they do? Fought. They fought all day and they slept all night. Two predicates, two actions they are doing. One is fighting and one is sleeping, right? And these two predicates are connected with another conjunction and. So this is what is compound subject and predicate. Hope you all understood what is subject and predicate children. Now we are going to do the exercises in workbook. Open your workbook.
Yes, open your workbook children. Block number 7, S1. Block number 7, S1. Write today's date 14-10-2020. 14-10-2020, S1, subject and predicate. Subject and predicate. See the first question children. Circle the subject and underline the predicate in each sentence. Circle the subject and underline the predicate in each sentence. A bit, they have done, given the example, okay. Meena typed on the computer keyboard. Here what is the subject? Meena. So we have to circle Meena. And what is the predicate? The rest of the action is the predicate sentence. Okay. See Bibit. Your gloves are made of wool. Your gloves are made of wool. In this, what is the subject children? Your gloves is the subject. Gloves is a thing, right? And the remaining sentence, are made of wool, is a predicate. Okay. See bit. Karthik is playing cricket with his friends. Karthik is playing cricket with his friends. In this, what is the subject? Karthik is the subject. And the remaining action in the sentence is the predicate. Okay. Debit and ebit you are going to do by yourself. Okay. See the next question. Complete the sentences by choosing the correct subject. Complete the sentences by choosing the correct subject. Here they have given the words in singular and plural children.
So after reading the sentence, you are going to choose the correct answer and write it down. A bit. Dash are large orange cats with black stripes. Dash are large orange cats with black stripes. Cats will be in orange color and black stripes, children? No. So which animal will be with that two large orange cats? Tigers. Now we are going to write tiger or tigers. Here the sentence is in plural, children. See, cats, stripes. Moreover, you have to remember either is, am, are given in singular or plural. Now are means it is a plural. So tigers will come. Start with the capital letter T-I-G-E-R-S. Tigers. Okay. See the B bit. The dash are playing outdoors. The dash are playing outdoors. Are means again it will be plural. So who will play outdoors? Children, right? Child, children. Which one will come? Child will be used only if it is a singular. Children will be used for the plural. So children. Write it down. C-H-I-L-D-R-E-N. Children. Like this you are going to do. You are going to read the sentence and do. C bit I'll explain. The dash is sailing from India to Africa. The dash is sailing from India to Africa. See here. Is means it is a singular. So ship. S-H-I-P. Ship. D bit and E bit you are going to do by yourself. Okay. Third question. Write a complete sentence using the given nouns as subjects. Write a complete sentence using the given nouns as subjects. Now you have to take this word as a subject and you are going to write one own sentence. Okay. See the fourth bit. Join the sentences to form compound subjects and predicates. We went to the shop. Full stop. We bought cats. I will write only one answer for you. We went to the shop and bought cats. See here. We are going to join the sentences to form compound subject and predicate. So, we went to shop to purchase cats. How did I write? We went to the shop and here I have used the conjunction and connected two action words, right? Predicates. Bought cats. Next, Raj helped his mother cook food. Sarah helped her mother cook food. Now, here subjects are different. Action is same. Mother cook food. Action is same. But the subject, Raj and Sarah, are different. So, we are going to combine these two nouns, two subjects by using a conjunction. Raj and Sarah. Helped. It is plural. So their mother cook food. Okay. Hope you understood. Complete your workbook and as well as your classwork, children. In the classwork, you are going to write grammar guide. Open grammar guide. In the classwork, draw the margins. Write the date as 14/10/2020. On the red line, block number 7, in the middle of the line, write writing a review story. In the first line, you are going to write this heading, subjects and predicates in sentences. And then write down this part neatly by leaving one line. Okay. So meet you in the next class, children, with the topic story review outline. Thank you.